This whole starter S40 with all the components cut, the end housing assembly, the body, the mounting bracket assembly, all this is painted red wherever the components have been cut. Even the disc springs, out of the 12 pairs, we have cut open 4 pairs of disc spring painted red to show the internal. The ball nut, you'll see the red color here, this is also cut. This is supposed to be solid. Now we have exposed this to show the cage and the ball bearings. This is the drive shaft, if you can see. This is a drive shaft inside. The two strut thread of the drive shaft. This whole thing is assembled. Yes, two strut thread, you can see. This one. The core assembly. The drive ratchet. This is the drive ratchet, has been cut, including the pinion. If you see the pinion, this is a section cut to expose the 5 strut thread. This is a 5 strut thread of the drive shaft. This is a working model. This is actually a working model of a cross-section starter. The trip link and the lock assembly, it is working.
You see, going up and down closely. This goes up and down.
This lock, you will see this will come down. So going up, and once you, this comes and downs and engages with the drive ratchet. The pinion, it moves over the 5 strut, returns back. The end housing assembly with the input gear, you see the whole core turns. So one can actually see all the functions working, including if you wind up with the trip lever up and then you further wind, please someone wind, wind, you will see the pinion moving forward. The lock will engage, the pinion is moving forward. Yeah, yes, it is skipped because the over teeth. Now, we will not wind beyond this. Once the pinion has moved forward, we will not wind it because it is not recommended to wind further because the balls may fall off because the after this stage, the springs want to be compressed. Of course, you can't wind by hand, but still we don't recommend it. At this position, see this return spring? It's totally compressed. This lock is engaging with the teeth of the drive ratchet. If you see the side view. Now, once you release it, the pinion turns and returns back. It returns back, the return spring is again open. So again we'll repeat. Once you are rotating the core assembly, the lever is upright for starting. You will gradually see this pinion will move forward. Move forward, this return spring has been compressed. On the event of releasing, the pinion will go back. Pinion goes back.